Welcome back to the OR, one of the ORs here at the New Brunswick Heart Centre at the St. John Regional Hospital. I'm joined by Bill O'Reilly, who is the manager of the Cardiac Perfusion Department. And Bill, we were talking earlier, a little bit earlier, with cardiac surgeon Dr. Hassan about just how important this piece of equipment is, and you know firsthand because you're using this on a daily basis.
This is what we do every day, yes. Hi, good morning, Cyril. Welcome to the cardiac OR.
Oh, thanks.
This is the heart-lung machine, as commonly referred to. And this allows us to perform cardiopulmonary bypass when the patients have open heart surgery here. And about 700 patients a year, more or less, come through the operating rooms here. And when they have the open heart surgery, their heart's stopped during the operation. So all their life support is maintained on this equipment you see in front of you. And it's very complex, a lot of different components to it. This particular machine you're looking at right here is about 11 to 12 years old right now. So what we're doing is upgrading our technology now to take us into the next decade.
Right.
And you can probably see there's a lot of add-on components of the machine, and some of that has been added on since this machine came here in 1990.
Because technology is always advancing and improving.
Right. Our patients are getting sicker, require more adequate care, they're in the operations longer nowadays, and so the equipment needs to lend itself to that so that our outcomes are as good as they were all along, even though we're dealing with sicker patients.
So I have to ask you, because I just find this completely fascinating, but what is it like to control somebody's lung and hearts while they're being operated on?
Well, I think over the years, as you get used to doing the job, it becomes almost second nature to you and on automatic. A lot of people in our business will compare us to like an airline pilot. The only difference is we only have one passenger instead of 200. But basically, that's what we're doing. We're in control of everything and a lot of different components. So during the actual operation, when the machine is running, the patient's blood is coming through here, we're controlling the temperature, we're controlling the normal blood gas levels, we're controlling the hemoglobin levels, the amount of hemodilution, the blood pressure the patient has. There's no heart rate, of course, so we don't have to worry about that.
Right.
The heart's stopped. And the oxygenation of the patient, because the lungs are turned off as well. So all those different things is what we're trained to do in our background.
Wow.
So that we maintain all those. So it sounds very complex, but after years and years of training and experience with it, it becomes very second nature to us.
Well, listen, thanks a lot for doing this, Bill. Really appreciate it.
Thanks for joining us.
All right.
Thanks very much.
Wow, incredible. All right. We'll see you back here at the St. John Regional Hospital in a little bit.